In order to draw with bitmaps in Storyboard Pro, you need to be working on a bitmap layer. So you can create a bitmap layer by going down to the Layers toolbar and clicking on the second icon, Add Bitmap Layer. Depending on whether you're on a bitmap layer or on a vector layer, the tool properties will change even if you have the same tool selected. So the tool that we have selected in this case is the brush tool. And you know that you've created a bitmap layer because it has this blue bar on the side. Let me click off the layer stack for a moment so that's more clear. So it has a blue bar here, whereas a vector layer has a gray bar. So drawing with the brush tool on a bitmap layer is a lot like painting in Photoshop. So you have a variety of tips here that you can select, and maybe I'll select this one right here. You can always change the size and the color, etc. And if I start drawing on this layer, what you essentially have is a soft looking, natural looking area, and it's actually all flattened into a single image, whether I draw without releasing my mouse or pen, or whether I draw individual strokes. And I can show you this by selecting the select tool and selecting this first drawn element, and you'll see that in fact, both objects are also flattened together, so they don't even need to be overlapping in order to have everything be flattened into a single element. With a single vector bounding box, that allows you to move these objects around, scale them, rotate them, etc. And this also applies if I decide to change the color or the texture of the brush. So say, for example, I choose the colored pencil and I use the color, maybe this burnt brownish color, and I do this. I'll take down the opacity a bit, increase the size. So if I do this and I try to select just the burnt orange color, you'll see that it has been flattened, in fact, with the purple strokes underneath. The advantage of using bitmap brushes over vector textured brushes is that they give you finer drawing control. You feel like you're really drawing with colored pencils or charcoal or pastel on paper. And it gives a really nice natural look, as you can see here, as well as what you can see here with Terry's glow, the layering of colors, how the yellow peaks out beneath the pink, or this golden color beneath the brown. You get a really lovely mixture of colors and textures together. And in addition to this, textured strokes on a bitmap layer are actually lighter than textured strokes on a vector layer. However, they are in fact not editable with the contour editor tool or the perspective tool, as you can see, as this entire group of tools is grayed out from the tools toolbar. Were I to click on a vector layer, you'll see that these tools then become enabled. So the contour editor, the perspective, the edit gradient texture, etc., as well as the pencil tool. So instead of manipulating the contours of individual strokes using the contour editor tool, you can actually just use the eraser tool and try to give it a similar size and softness as the brush that you were using in order to get that kind of natural feeling that you get of using the real life medium. One last disadvantage is also that any of the drawn elements that you create on a bitmap layer is obviously resolution dependent. So if you decide to zoom in to these textures, you can see at a certain point they start to look pixelated. So that's a bit of a disadvantage. Also, if you're going to do a zoom out and you need all of a sudden to scale up drawn elements that had been created with textured brushes on a bitmap layer, those elements would also become pixelated. So you really have to plan ahead with how you're going to use bitmap drawings. But of course, once again, their recommended use is when you're going to create lovely texture drawings with lots of colors and shading.